Is Bitcoin crashing? Look, just the other day it was like everything's going to the moon, and now here we are, we're saying it's a crash. Bitcoin's no longer going to be sustainable. You know, coal for burning energy for mining and this and that and Tesla and what's going on? And so today I want to jump into you and ask, you know, is Bitcoin crashing? Is crypto crashing? Or is it a great opportunity to buy right now? There's two different views. I've talked to a lot of my entrepreneur friends out there, a lot of people online and groups I'm a part of, because here's the first tip. Do your own research, but be part of a group. Don't allow the mastermind concept to fall short when it comes to investments. You want to be able to get the best and the most information that you possibly can to help you and your portfolio grow and to help other people, right? And so, but you got to make your own decisions. And so anyway, I'm taking this collective effort as I make this video. And I will tell you, last night, I was up until about midnight looking at crypto and what's Bitcoin and Ethereum doing. Because I'm very heavily invested in Ethereum and I want to play a larger play. And so it was dropping last night, but I woke up at 4 a.m. I started seeing that it was tanking. And then by, 7 o'clock, it was all hell broke loose. So what is it? A lot of people say that everything started when Elon Musk, that's who I'm thinking. I'm thinking Nikola Tesla, right? When Elon Musk was kind of gave that report about Bitcoin and the mining and how it's, the worst for the economy. And then the rumors were leaking that he sold all of his Bitcoin, which started getting people to freak out. And then all of a sudden people started selling and then mass fear hit. And you got to understand, when people are in a position where they might even be losing money or are losing money, that fear kicks in, because I'm hearing on both sides of the street, crypto is one of the most horrible things. You're going to lose your shirt. And then I'm hearing, hey, it's the wave of the future. It's going to be, bigger and better than anything else out there. And I started talking with some friends and I started thinking, like, large institutions are in the game. And my thoughts are, if large institutions are finally in the game, they're getting better returns than they do in the stock market. And so my thought process is, and I want you guys to know, I'm no financial advisor. This is no financial or investment knowledge or advice. So just making that clear. But my thoughts are, like, they're going to get the maximize the returns. Now, they might not like the way things are done and how it's produced and, with the energy inefficiencies and stuff like that. But hopefully this is a great awakening for the blockchain and the dev teams to really start cleaning things up and be more eco-friendly. And so, and then also there's things like Ethereum where their gas prices are way too high to acquire, coins. And so there's so many different factors out there, but that's just my thoughts, right? That's my thoughts, that thinking that it's here for the wave of the future. There's going to be changes. There's probably going to be more regulations, right? But at the same time, we got to ask ourselves, what do we do? How do we take advantage of this, if anything? So as I'm doing this video, China's not even up, and we're going to see what happens, once China gets up and plays out. Usually around my time, 2:30 in the morning is on average when big moves are made. It's just when America's sleeping, right? And so we'll see what happens tonight. But I remember I woke up and it got down, Ethereum got to $1,995. Bitcoin at that point was roughly, the low point was $31,663. And so it broke the weekly 33,000 support. And we, after it broke the, what was it? I think the $39,000 support, we thought it was going to drop significantly and plummet. And so 30,000, and let me back up. I think it was the 38 or 39,000 was the 200-day moving average. I don't have that in front of me, but going off the top of my head. And once it broke that, then we saw it go down to the 33,000 and below. So if it breaks the $30,000 support line, we might be in for something, crazy and just a massive sale. We'll see. I don't see it. I think it's bouncing back as I'm speaking right now. It's about $40,000 right now. Again, we'll see what China says, but this is the thing. You have to get clear. A lot of people, they freak out when they see a 30, a 40, a 50% swing. And if that's the, if you see going in the opposite direction that big, you got to ask yourself, am I meant to play in this game? Because right now, cryptocurrency is the wild, wild west. There's no regulations hardly. And so, but you got to start thinking, what can I handle? What is my risk tolerance? And the biggest thing, I have friends that are over leveraged. They're losing a lot of money because they're over leveraged and they don't have their stop losses. And so I would think if I'm going to play in that over leveraged position, that I'm going to have my stop losses so that if something like this did take place, I was good. I took profit. Now, I always like to ask people, are you a long-term holder? You a trader? Like, where are you in your portfolio? Because that will determine kind of how you're looking at this. What's the lens that you're looking from? But my question to you is, what are you going to do from here? If you're big into crypto, right? A lot of my entrepreneur friends, I can't speak for everyone. I can only speak for me. But a lot of my friends that I'm talking to, the high performing entrepreneurs that have business and that liquidity to throw into the game, they're going in a big way. Now they may, it may drop again. It may drop even more and it very well could, but we're starting to see it bounce back a little. The question is it just stabilizing? Is it going to shoot back up from here and go further and at all time highs? Is it getting ready for a downswing? Right? What is it? The black cat that they talk about where it looks like it's going back up, it's stabilizing, boom, it drops. Right? And so where are we? No one has a crystal ball, but you got to ask, what are you going to do from here? And for me, I knew that when Ethereum hit an all-time high, I said if it hits 35%, if it has a 35% or more drop, I was going to do it. Now, the problem was that by the time I woke up and got everything rolling, Coinbase and Coinbase Pro, which I have a lot of Ethereum through, and you know, a lot of us in the US, we have to kind of use that platform if you're not doing other things, but we won't mention them here on today's show. And I'm by no means an expert. I'm just giving you guys a high level overview. And if I was coaching me through this, what would I say? But anyway, everything was crashed, right? You couldn't get on anything. I think Robinhood was allowing some people. I was trying to deposit, you know, a large sum of money in both of them and it was glitching. And I was just like, and by the time I got money in and get ready to sell or buy, things were starting to go up and I probably lost out on $400 gain on it, but it is what it is. In the grand scheme of things, I'm looking, my belief system is, and a lot of the entrepreneurs that I'm talking to, is that the blockchain technology is here. It's going to be here. Now, how it evolves is a different question. However, they believe that they're going to go up. Now, each person has their own input on that, you know, technical analysis, fundamental analysis, whatever you guys use, whether it's you just pulling something out of your butt. Because honestly, I don't always play by the analysis rules. What I like to do is I like to look at the patterns and people's psychology and kind of make some predictions from there. So I'm not going to get into my predictions because there's people out there with technical analysis, fundamental analysis who may not agree. But my position is I think it's going to be worth a lot more in the future than it is now. And so with that, I'm betting and I'm putting my money where my mouth is that it's going up. And so, and a lot of my friends, they're putting in 5-6 figures, right? We're getting into the game because you got to see, what are you willing to lose? Are you willing to lose 10 grand? Are you willing to lose that 3 grand? Are you willing to lose that 50 or 100 grand? If it happened, would your life be okay? Would you be able to survive? You have to think that way because you shouldn't be investing or betting what you're not willing to lose. So I don't see the market going back to what it was in 2017. As I look, as I pull up, let me go back to where Bitcoin was. You know, back in 2017, 2018, it was around the price of 15,000, and then we had this huge drop, and we got all the way down to, I think our lowest point was somewhere around 3,000 a coin, or maybe 3,770, I think was the lowest. And now we're at all-time highs. And so we got to ask ourselves, is this going to be an M where we're going to have, you know, it's dropping and now we're going to have this big spike and then this drastic decline over the next rest of the year? Or is it kind of like a head and shoulders pattern where we have this up and then we go to an up all-time high even more, you know, where it, some people are predicting that Bitcoin could be around that $80,000 to $100,000 a coin mark by the end of the year. We'll see. Is that true? I don't know. I don't have a crystal ball. But you got to ask yourself, what are you going to do? Is the market really crashing, or is this a red day's a great opportunity to buy in? Where do you think it's going to be? Everyone I'm talking to, be careful. Be careful where you're buying, how much you're buying, but also a lot of people I'm talking about says this is just part of playing in the game. A lot of things are changing. We're looking at seeing where the supports are, but my long-term opinion is it's going to be worth a lot more than it is right now. No crystal ball there, just seeing patterns. And honestly, you know, for Bitcoin to get back to, what was it, 62,000 was part of the high there. I'm looking here. It's going to be a little bit. We'll see how much it bounces back, and you know, if large institutions are gathering in and want to get more profits or whatnot. But the market caps are taking a hit, and obviously the prices are too. So this is an opportunity. These are the moments. Hear me clearly. These are the moments that define your future. You're either going to, and I was telling, I sent my buddy a text today and I said this, I said, either I'm going to be in a position where I paid a little too much and it's going to drop and I could have bought more at a cheaper price, or I'm going to be in a position where I said, gosh, I wish I would have bought more. And I can't tell you on this ride up in this bull market how many times I said that. And are we entering into a bear market? We'll see. But I think I'm in a position, and where I think is I should have bought more. Now, here's the thing. Coinbase only allows you to enter $38,000 or $35,000 a day, which is kind of frustrating. I might have to see. I think you can actually up that limit, but you got to do some verification things. But I wish I could have got a lot more than that in there. So I just think it's going to be better for over the long haul. It's going to go back up. How much, I don't know, but are you going to be one of those people who says, I wish I would have put more in? But if you do put more in, why are you doing it? What are you basing this on? And sometimes I get a little kind of like optimistic. That's just my personality as a high eye on the disc profile. We're very optimistic. But you got to ask yourself, where do you see? Because this could be life-changing income. If you have 50 Ethereum coins, and let's just say at $3,000, a coin, and James Wong said this a little, I think it was a week or two ago, from he used to work at ArkFest, and he said that if Ethereum can capture 1% of the market space, that it could potentially see $40,000 highs. I'm not saying it's going to, it could be, but if it did, and you had 50 coins, well, that's a roughly $1.8 million profit. But what does it take to get there? It takes 150 grand, you know? And so are you willing to potentially lose that to get there? At least at today's prices right now, because let me just see here, let's back up. Because Ethereum is at 2684 as I speak, 2672, sorry. And we're gonna see, you know, because it broke that 4,000 mark, and people were saying that it could hit 10,000 by the end of the year. We'll see, it could go down to 1100. Right, which would have been a 75% loss from its all-time highs. So we'll see. You got to ask yourself, what are you willing to do? Because it's in these moments where fear of what's going on is overtaking people. Some people don't believe in cryptocurrency and they say it's just a bunch of fluff and you're all going to lose your money. They might be right. But if you can capture profits along the way, or if you capture a lot of profits along the way and it changes your family's financial future, where it allows you to open up that business or take that trip or that vacation, I'm willing to put the money on the line and take that risk, right? But I also have the belief system that you got to look and say, okay, great. If you lose that money, can you get it back? Do you have a vehicle? And if you're one of those people who work a job, it's going to take a long time potentially to get that money back. But if you have a side hustle, you have a business, or you're an entrepreneur and your business is flourishing, you can be able to full time for you. You can make a bigger impact. So It's a game. It's a game. No one has all the answers. No one has the right answers. You got people like Elon Musk that they say is manipulating the markets, and you know everyone was loving it when they were in Bitcoin and crypto and Ethereum, when Elon Musk was tweeting about how amazing it is and how their company invested and skyrocketed. But now everyone's pissed at him because of what he's doing. So it's like, what goes up must come down, right? I don't know. You got to ask yourself, what are you going to do for your future? Are you going to play it safe? Are you going to go all in? Are you going to risk? What is it for you? And it can change your destiny, but don't allow yourself to get greedy. Don't allow your emotions to get involved. Know why you're doing it. Remove the emotions and go from there. And you got to be willing to lose the money. So do I think the market's crashing? I don't know. Do I think it's going to bounce back? I don't know. But I think in the long run, it's going to go up. So we'll see. We'll see how these next 24 hours play out. Hopefully we get a little bit more of a dip. Hopefully we get it down to like, maybe for me, Ethereum down to like 1500. I would love that. So, but we'll see. There's a lot of things happening right now. It's down 23%. It was this morning, it was down 45% at one point. I was loving it, not even though a lot of my profits were getting eaten up. But we'll see what happens with the altcoins too. So with that, I've been rambling for 16 minutes. So I'm going to wrap up here. My prediction, you know, again, I don't have a crystal ball. I'm not using fundamental analysis or technical analysis or anything like that yet as I share this. But my thoughts are from a psychology perspective, you know, it's like when you dated someone, like you went out on a date, you had a great time, something happened, it was a little weird and just didn't work out. And you guys stopped texting, but then time went on and you're like, maybe I should reach back out to that person. Maybe we should go out again. And you text that person, right? It's like, once you've had a taste, it allows you and you moved into that mentally and emotionally, you want to go after more. You want to have it again. I'm just thinking from a patterns perspective that I can't see people pulling out and never jumping back in, especially those that make great profits, these institutions. And a lot of people in the masses, I think it's just an army, a small army getting more momentum. It's going to kind of charge up and then shoot back up. That's my thoughts. Again, no financial advice, but that's, I'm putting my money where my mouth is. I got a lot of people doing it too. So we'll see. So anyway, with that, you got to make your decision. Is Bitcoin crashing or is it an incredible opportunity to buy right now when we have about a 40% off sale? So it's all about how you see it, folks. It's all about how you see it. With that, tune in, subscribe, hit that thumbs up button, hit that or comment below, and then also hit that subscribe button. We're coming at you 3 videos a week. If you're a high-performing entrepreneur looking to go to that next level in the areas of business, relationships, and mindset, you want to tune into this channel, hit that notification button so that you can get notified when these videos come out. With that, I'm going to go look at investing a little bit more. You guys have a great one. Joe Mafu, Master Life by Design. Have a great one. See ya.